I keep on telling homeowners, whenever you are constructing the biodigester, don't let the plumber or the biodigester constructor put a vent pipe on it or anywhere around the digester unless it's going all the way up to the top of the building or above the window level. This is my simple education to you. The best way to do a vent for a toilet seat and a biodigester is to have it above the window level. The idea of biodegradable biodigester simple means that you are constructing a digester that is not a holding tank. It is not a holding tank in the sense that the human waste and the water are not going to be together, which is what the septic tank does. This is a digester, or this is a technology that means that you are rapidly separating the human waste from the wastewater or the flush unit water, and then you are sending that water into a soakaway pit, a soakaway chamber, a drainage system, or whatever option is available to you. And then you are maintaining or retaining the human waste in the digester for biodegradation and microorganisms to feed on it. What this simply means is that the human waste will biodegrade by itself, and then the water will go away immediately you flush it. So it's not going to be a holding tank, which means that there's not going to be heat in it, or there's not going to be a mixture of the human waste with the water, which will make it smell, and thereby as well as introduce maggots and other stuff that make the human waste smell. So you do not need a tank on it, because the moment you separate the water from the human waste, the feces will not smell. That's how the technology works. And then your biodegradation will take place. So the vent pipe that you are doing, ideally, is for the toilet seats that are coming from the house. The toilet seats coming from the house are being done just for the human waste that might get stuck in the system. And then the vent pipe is supposed to take away the human waste that might get stuck in the system, right, in the pipes, so that it might not return scent to the room. It might help take away those scents. And in your worst case scenario, let's say the digester is not working well and the biodegradation is not happening, then obviously the vent pipes will also help take away all those scents. So that's the purpose of the vent pipe. So putting the vent pipe on the biodigester is actually inviting flies and any other insects that might have access to the digester and possibly render it ineffective from going in it. That if you put a vent pipe on it and it's a short one, that's exactly what it's going to do. It might invite insects, it might invite flies and any other insect that might render the biodigester ineffective. So any vent on it, one, it's not supposed to invite scent into the room. It's supposed to go above the window level so that anything else that is on it might be taken out of it. And two, so that when it rains, water does not pass through the vent holes and then go and render your biodigester ineffective or go and spoil the digester. Because all that you are trying to prevent is to not let water be in the digester tank. But if you put a short vent on it, it means that whenever it rains, water can pass through that place and go and spoil your biodigester and prevent it from working effectively. So that's my advice to you. Anybody who is constructing a biodigester for you, or any plumber who is working on an already constructed biodigester, and he said that let's put a short vent on it, oh let's put a vent by the side, oh let's put the vent here, please tell him no, we don't want a vent on this thing. The vent must be part of the building construction. It must be part of the toilet solution for the whole house, not necessarily for the biodigester. This is your vent, a typical vent pipe that we like. Ideally, this is how it should be. The vent shouldn't be on the building. You can have a chamber, inspection chamber, just for the digester. In case there's anything, you can open it up and look inside. But have your vent hidden nicely on the wall. It can be a 2-inch pipe, it can be 3 inches. And then let it out all the way to the top. And then let it come out. Dreamhouse biodigesters, constructors of simple on-site biodegradable biodigesters, and educational videos on how to construct a biodigester. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe and be part of us. We are a community rapidly growing, for people who are interested in how to manage their human waste sustainably. Subscribe and be part of this community. The video that is showing up next, the video right here that will be showing, will explain to you further how to construct a biodigester for your dream house.